Hello guys, I'm Jalaj from Dalal Share Investor. So today I want to discuss about the most important thing which like lot of investor might be knowing and but or some might be worried about their investment in debt funds. So my question is, can debt funds crash in recession? So the answer is yes, they can crash. So the meaning of crash is not like your investment amount will go by 10%, 20%, but your principal might be at risk. Because say like whenever a person is investing in debt, he's not investing for wealth building, he's investing for protection of his wealth. So the investment in the debt funds is only done for the protection of the wealth which you have already created. So in the last 1 month, we have seen a lot of turmoil in Indian equity markets and all over like global equity markets. A lot of funds have crashed just because like stock markets have performed very poorly. So today I want to discuss about this kind, how we can see the debt funds which are at risk and how to manage that thing. So these are list of a debt fund which the investor might be already familiar with. So I will not go into individual debt funds one by one. Just I want to discuss the broader category. So where that debt funds invest and how we can identify all those things. So debt fund basically invest in the corporate bonds or NCDs, debentures, government securities or RBI securities. So these investments are for short-term and long-term perspective, and they usually borrow for their day-to-day activities or starting of a new project or paying off old debt, something like that. Out of this, like whenever a debt fund investing in the corporate bonds, it is generally risky or say NCD. Because corporates, as you already be knowing that a lot of corporates have generally a high debt. So in order to pay previous debt, they raise new debt by these NCDs or corporate bonds. So in such conditions, your investment amount can get under risk. So generally, like most of investors don't see it like that. Here I have taken an example of a debt fund, which is the SGFC credit risk fund. So a credit risk fund is like a fund which actually bet on slightly lower grade investment securities and generated good return on that. So here, like the minimum exposure to such securities is 65%, which is considerably higher than other debt funds. So these funds generally perform good in a good market scenario, but since the scam of DHFL and all Yes Bank fiasco happened, the debt funds are not considerable that safe which they used to be. So where like investors generally think that they are getting 7% instead of 4% or 5% in the bank, it's well and good. But the thing is that the amount of risk which you are taking for the reward, it's not worth. It's better to invest in equity markets than investing in debt funds. Or if you want to just keep your money safe, better to keep in the bank account, because that is much more safer given the present scenarios. So here I've taken an example of HDFC credit risk fund. So here's a snapshot of this fund. So I've got this information from Value Research. So this is the page, Value Research, from where I've got, and I've mentioned the link in the description in this my post. So here you can see that the fund has invested in a lot of securities. So some are debentures, some are zero coupon bonds, some are bonds. So the main thing which we have to see, the companies which the fund has invested. So here like we can see the Tata Steel, Punjab National Bank, Tata Power, Vedanta, Jio, Shriram, City Union Finance. So all these companies are like the fund has invested, but the main things are Vedanta and Tata Steel, and Tata Motors, all these companies are having a huge amount of debt, and these companies' equity share also are like trading multi-year low. Like I think they are 6 to 7 year low. So in order to pay the principal and interest, the company has to, maybe they have to raise another NCD or another debenture bond. So such kind of things becomes complicated, and you never know like when a company defaults on your interest and principal. So given the circumstances, I think one should avoid debt funds. If you still want to invest in any debt fund, go for a fund where they have invested in the government securities or RBI bonds. So say like in this fund, if you take an example of the return, the fund has given a negative return in 1 month. So most of investors will argue that like they are not investing for 1 month, 2 months, but it's just a coronavirus like epidemic has just started, and you never know like the companies can default and so on. So why to take the risk? You know, finally, like you will be getting 8% or 9% maximum. So why to take the risk for the 2 or 3%? It's better to invest in equity market than investing in the debt funds, because the risk and reward is not that much of worth. So the few things which I think you should consider before investing in any debt fund, so that like horizon should not be very small. It should not be less than 6 months, because given the current circumstances, it's risky. And still, like you want to invest, go for checking for the portfolio. If you are not aware of like companies which they have invested, so it's better to avoid that fund. Funds such as credit risk and gilt funds should not be taken for any short term, because like gilt funds are the funds which invest in government securities. So the funds which and the securities which are provided by the government. So these kind of funds are a bit volatile with the monetary policy. So if your horizon is like less than 1 month, then in that case, like the fund will be a bit volatile, because given the circumstances, like RBI has constantly been decreasing the interest rates. So these funds, so you might be getting good return in this fund, gilt funds. But when the RBI will start increasing the interest rate, then this fund will give negative return. So for short term, gilt fund should be avoided, or the longer term, may say like 3 years or 5 years, they could be taken. And the last thing is like fund size, which fund should they also take consider, because if the fund size is too low and the fund gets too much of the redemptions, then the fund NAV can also fall. So one should avoid that also. So here, like I've taken another type of debt fund, which is your ultra short bond fund. So it is also for like 1 or 2 years, and the investment horizon for 1 or 2 years. Still, like this debt fund has given very poor returns, just because of that. Like if this fund was holding Idea Vodafone debt papers. So now, like if you will go for the portfolio, the fund is not currently holding, because like the fund has removed that thing from its portfolio, and it is like overwritten that thing. So it is very like necessary, like you should do all this cross check before investing in the any debt fund. So here's another type of debt fund, which is known as liquid fund. Liquid funds are considerably safe, because like they invest in high grade of securities. So most like government securities and all that. And here, like you can see, it's invested in RBI bonds and GOV, but they still have invested in Ashok Leyland, IDFC First Bank, Bank of Baroda. But still they are very, very safe. But the fund still have given a negative return in short time. I think, but this kind of funds can handle the circumstances. But if you want to be too sure, so So better to avoid any kind of debt fund and keep your money in the bank accounts. That is the most important thing which one should adhere to. Okay guys, I think this tutorial has helped you in regarding the knowing of the debt funds. So if you have any questions, drop down in the comment section. Okay, thank you.